Hello everyone, this is Dr. Prashant and welcome back to Public Health Series. In this video, I'll be briefly talking about health education. So to start with the introduction, health education is any combination of learning experiences designed to predispose, enable and reinforce voluntary adoption of behavior conducive to health. So it aims to increase knowledge and awareness and is an important component of health promotion. So now coming to IEC, that is Information, Education and Communication. It aims to increase awareness, change attitudes and bring about a change in specific behaviors. It also focuses on sharing information and ideas in a way that is culturally sensitive and acceptable to the community using appropriate channels, messages and methods. Next is communication, which is about exchanging information, sharing ideas and knowledge. So basically it's a two-way process in which information, thoughts, ideas, feelings or opinions are shared through words, actions or signs in order to reach a mutual understanding. So the active involvement of people will lead to a good communication. And the effectiveness of communication depends on the following characteristics. First is source or the sender. So the factors related are attitudes, knowledge, communication skills, relevance to cultural and social systems. Next is message. The message has to be clear, simple, specific, factual, appropriate, timely and relevant. Third is channel, through which the message is sent has to be appropriate, relevant, accessible and affordable. Next is receiver. Similar to source, it also includes attitudes, perceptions, communication skills, knowledge, cultural and social system. And the last is feedback, which can be immediate or delayed feedback, constructive or positive feedback, and this feedback can be the motivation for change. Now coming to types of communication, we already know that there are two types of communication, right? One is interpersonal communication and next is mass communication. So coming to health communication, it is basically to promote the health of individuals and communities. So it attempts to change or reinforce a set of behaviors in a large-scale target audience regarding a specific health problem in a predefined period of time. So a public health communication strategy usually has three components: planning, intervention, and last is monitoring and evaluation. So these are some of the factors to be considered in planning an IEC activity. First is demographic factors, next is socioeconomic factors along with environmental and cultural factors. Third is health, social and health services issues. Fourth is factors influencing health behaviors. And fifth is community structures and institutions. Now coming to the steps in designing an IEC activity. First, we need to conduct a need assessment. Next, we need to establish behavioral objectives that will contribute to achieving the goal. Third, we need to develop IEC messages, followed by selecting appropriate channels and tools. Next, mobilize resources, draw up an action plan. Next, implement a strategy, followed by monitoring and evaluation. And the last step is review and replanning. Next is participatory approach, which actively involves people in discussions and practical activities, facilitates effective communication, enables people to think more deeply about their problems and to develop solutions themselves. So these are some of the participatory methods, which include brainstorming, discussion pairs, group work, a decision-making task, writing letters to a problem page as a starting point for a discussion, also role plays, dramas, poetry, songs and stories, along with pictures, flip charts and videos. So now let's understand this with an example. So I have given an example for both problem and also for the possible IEC response. So in this case, the problem is the cardiovascular diseases among old age people. So it includes high rates of chronic diseases among old age people, and community diagnosis shows that utilization of healthcare service in old age is also low, and that there are high levels of gender discrimination in treatment seeking and fear about high expenses for treating the old age diseases. So this is the problem. So the possible IEC response could be, it needs to promote safer health promoting behavior changes along with friendly physical exercises, and also to change discriminatory attitudes towards older people, particularly with diseases and disabilities by the family members especially. Now coming to the communication approaches, basically there are three types of approaches. One is individual approach, which include personal contacts, home visits and personal letters. Second is group approach, which include lectures, demonstrations, discussion methods. And under discussion methods, it can be group discussion, panel discussion, symposium, workshop, conferences, seminars and role plays. And coming to the third approach, that is mass approach, where it includes television, radio, newspaper, printed materials, posters, internet, folk methods, health museums and exhibitions. And last is direct mailing or door-to-door distribution. Now coming to the factors affecting effective communication. First is physiological factors. Examples include difficulties in hearing, expression, etc. Second is psychological factors, which include emotional disturbances, mental health issues. All these things come under psychological factors. Third is environmental factors, which include noise, poor visibility, congestion of the space, etc. And last is cultural factors, which include the literacy status, customs and beliefs, religion, etc. Now coming to the last part, that is behavior change communication, also called as BCC. So it is a part of an integrated, multi-level, interactive process with communities aimed at developing tailored messages and approaches using a variety of communication channels. So it aims to foster positive behavior, promote and sustain individual, community and societal behavior change, and maintain appropriate behavior. So it's better focused and targeted form of IAC, and this concept of behavior change communication is gradually replacing IAC in several promotional activities and healthcare programs. Thank you.